EcoFlow is pretty much the gold standard when it comes to power stations. DJI is also a gold standard, but in a completely different industry. Although this year, they've taken a jab at being the hot new girl on the block in the power station game. I'm not gonna lie, they did a pretty good job. Funny enough, even though EcoFlow has been around forever and is kind of like the gold standard, it was actually employees that left DJI that started EcoFlow in the first place. Now, we've never hidden the fact that we are fans of EcoFlow and most of their products, but when we reviewed the DJI Power 1000 and even the Little Brother 500, we were really impressed. So today we wanted to put them head to head, see how they compare, and see which one might be best for you. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. We've put some decent testing and mileage on both of these units, and although they're both just portable power stations, they're actually intended for two completely different people. As always, we will leave links to both of these down below, as well as any discount codes that we're able to squeeze out of both DJI and EcoFlow to help save you guys some money. But before we get into our experiences and our kind of recommendations, we're gonna hit you guys with a super quick side-by-side teardown in case you're not already familiar with one of or both of these products. Both of these units pass the tiny baby lift test. The DJI weighs 1.5 pounds more at 28.5 pounds, but both of these are super light and easy to move. They both have a 1,024 watt hour battery bank. Both is lithium iron phosphate and rated for 3,000 cycles to 80% life capacity, or whatever they all say. The Delta 3 Plus is expandable. The DJI units are not. EcoFlow has an 1800 watt inverter. DJI has a 2200 watt inverter. The EcoFlow has two 500 watt solar inputs totaling in at 1000 watts total. DJI has two 400 watt inputs totaling in at 800 watts total. Though the EcoFlow's inputs are dedicated solar inputs, if you're charging this with solar, you're actually taking away from the SDC ports that you would be using to charge drones and whatever. Both of these units can be charged up just by plugging them into a regular wall outlet in your house. This one charges with 1500 watts, this one's 1200 watts, pretty close. Both of these will charge in less than an hour. And in terms of ports, it's pretty much the exact same. The EcoFlow does have four additional wall outlets, as well as a 12 volt car socket and two barrel connectors. The DJI has less wall plugs, but it does have two of these SDC light ports, which are basically for like quick charging drones. You can plug in your solar adapters into there, all kinds of stuff you can do with these two little plugs. And when it comes to the MSRP on both of these, this one is $799, this one is $855, although both of them are usually on some sort of sale. But let's get a little bit more into the edge that each of these units kind of have on each other. The Delta 3 Plus is like a jack of all trades. This thing is good at a lot of stuff, but it doesn't really excel at just one thing. But when you put it head to head against the DJI Power 1000, there's a few places this thing shines. And first up, it just has more 120 volt wall outlets right here on the front. Now, three of them don't have a ground. They're meant for something a lot more light duty, like a light or something simple, but there's still six outlets on the front of this unit, which adds a ton of versatility, especially if you're trying to use this for like home backup when there's a power outage or something like that. And you're gonna be plugging in real appliances that require these plugs. The DJI only has two, so you're a lot more limited with that unit. The Delta 3 is also expandable. This unit specifically has its own expansion batteries, or it's supposed to. EcoFlow says it does, but we can't find them on their website. It also works with Delta 2 expansion batteries, so if you already have existing ones, it works with Delta Pro 3. It works with basically anything that you can use this little adapter and this cable to connect to, which is a huge pro. So if you already have EcoFlow products, you can go ahead and just expand the storage capacity of this unit with those products. Again, something that the DJI just doesn't have the ability to do. This unit charges a tiny bit faster. It's got 200 watts more on the solar input and 300 watts more on the AC. Is that even an edge? I don't know. As well as having a bunch of additional wall plugs, this unit does have a 12 volt car socket on the back right here, as well as two additional 12 volt barrel connectors. So if you're like a hardcore overlander or camper and you wanna use this, this unit does have the extra versatility that a lot of your stupid little camping gadgets, I have them, so I shouldn't say that, but a lot of your little camping gear and stuff is gonna wanna use these plugs. So this does lend itself nicely to that. And keeping in line with all the extra plugs and stuff, behind this door, you have the dedicated solar plugs. So that's another thing that DJI doesn't have. Their solar plugs actually take away from you being able to use certain plugs while you're charging it with solar. This one, you can have solar running into it and it doesn't affect any of the other plugs on the unit. And the last thing is that the Delta 3 and basically every EcoFlow product ever has an app. The app is pretty good. It lets you do actually quite a bit of stuff, especially with like newer units like this one. You can basically just turn everything on and off from an app. You can schedule tasks to turn on, turn off. It's got like storm warning or whatever they call that new feature. There's a bunch of stuff that you can do on the app. You can control it remotely. It'll send you notifications, that kind of stuff. It's not a deal breaker, but having an app is pretty cool, especially if you're running this far away from you or whatever. It'll notify you if it's getting low or if it starts charging or whatever. It's just nice to know. And kind of like I've already said, the DJI is geared towards a completely different group of people, and the edge that it has is an edge for those people. So the biggest thing that I would say this has an edge on is everything is forward facing. Every in and out plug is on the front. Something like actually most other power stations utilize like the front and the back or the front and the side or whatever. So this, especially if you're creative and you just have a ton of stuff jammed in your car or whatever, you can have this pushed way into a corner. And as long as you have access to just this front panel, you could charge it, discharge it, do whatever you want straight from one side, which is huge. I really like having access to everything in one face. It also just has that built-in DJI personality, starting from as simply when you turn it on or off. It sounds exactly like all the other DJI gear you already have. It makes you feel nice, warm, and fuzzy. It's got two of these SDC ports, so you can go ahead and fast charge drones. They actually have a list on their website of what drones fast charge in what amount of time, but these are like DJI specific plugs. So if you already have existing gear from them, you're gonna like those. You can also get a ton of accessories because it's DJI. So you can get the little carrying bag that we have. It has pouches to put all your cables and your accessories. It also just has like a shoulder strap. So sure, it's not expandable, but it's kind of geared towards someone that doesn't need to expand it, but wants to take it on the go, throw it over your shoulder. Everything's already loaded in that bag and you're off to do whatever you're doing, filming or creating content. And that's kind of who this is geared for. And speaking of creating content, this is the quietest small power station we have. The only thing that competes with how quiet this is the EcoFlow Delta Pro Ultra, which is massive and like $6,000. So that's really nice. If you're trying to shoot a video, for example, I could have this in the corner running all of our lights, charging camera batteries, charging the drone, doing a ton of stuff, and you don't hear it. It's not gonna interrupt the footage. It's not gonna be annoying. It's just in the corner doing its thing quietly. And it's very rare to find a unit that is quiet like that. This unit, sure, it only has 220 volt plugs, but it has a bigger inverter. For example, like a microwave, my microwave is like 1800 watts. If you were to run it on the EcoFlow, who cares about microwaves? That's just, I was going nowhere with that. Point is, you can go ahead and you can actually use a little bit of a bigger items with this power station, and it has a bigger surge. So if you accidentally go over what it's rated for, this will be a little bit more forgiving than something like the EcoFlow. And that mixed with the quiet sound and the SDC ports and all that kind of stuff, you're able to switch this from slow charging to fast charging. You got the USBs. It just kind of feels, to us at least, like there was more time and energy and care put into building this. Like when we tested it, everything kind of works like you want it to. Like there's no, we never had any really weird random problems. It's quiet, it's functional, and it does what it's supposed to, and we like that. And finally, this guy also has a little brother. So if you're not trying to spend as much money or you don't need as big of a power bank, you can go ahead and get basically the exact same unit in the 500 watt range. Whereas when you do the EcoFlows, when you start stepping up or down in sizes, you lose plugs and ports and things just go crazy. So it's really nice that this is basically identical minus one SDC port in a smaller package. So at the end of the day, both of these are pretty good units. If you've already narrowed down your decision, I don't really think you can make a wrong one. The Delta 3 Plus is better suited for someone that needs the extra plugs and ports. If you're planning on using this more for home backup, or you're like a camper overlander that needs way too many appliances to be used. Inversely, if you have actually no idea what you need or what you want, having more plugs and options is never a bad thing. Or if you want a power station that you think in the future you might want to expand on, I would say the Delta 3 Plus is probably a great place to start. On the other hand, if you're a creator or you already have DJI products that you use all the time, something like this probably will be way more than you need. Sure, it's a little bit more limited in terms of the plugs, but it's kind of meant to charge camera batteries and drones and things while you're on the go, and laptops and stuff like that. Most of them you can use the USBs with combination of these plugs. You'll still have way more power than you need. If you want something that's very quiet so you can use it in and around where you're creating or sleeping while you're camping or something like that, if you want to be able to just throw everything in a DJI specific bag, cables, all that kind of stuff that you're gonna be bringing around with you, throw it over your shoulder and just get on the go. And if you're just kind of limited on space, you want to be able to just shove a power station in a corner and still have access to everything that you need, I'd say go for the DJI. That's our opinion though. At the end of the day, if you're still not sure, just go with your gut. Use the links in the description down below. It helps support the channel, and feed Tiny Baby because he's a menace when he's hungry. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys. I'll catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.